All right, good day, welcome. Shout out to my groupies. How you booze doing today? So this is going to be for the sign of Leo, all right? What do we have for Leo? These are general messages. It's whosever energy is the strongest that I'm picking up on, all right? And the messages that the energies I work with feel are the most important, all right? So let's see what I have for the Leos today. This is your January end of the month reading, but anytime you come across this, all right, my readings are timeless. So when it finds you, it finds you. Feel free to hit that like, subscribe, and share button, all right, because it gets the video out for those that it may be for. So, all right, let's see what we have for the Leos. Welcome to any newcomers. I don't know why. The minute I'm going to shut my platform down is when people want to subscribe, but it's like this one lady that I like to watch because she's excellent. She really put things into perspective, all right? I don't pay for readings, but that reading was so for me, and yeah, it really put things into perspective. Even myself as a tarot reader, I don't like to read my own energy, all right? Just like I don't like to read for friends and family. It's like my dude told me, he's like, will you do a reading for me? And it's like, I don't like doing readings for friends and family because it's kind of like a subconscious thing where it's like, I already know everything that's going on in the people that are closest to me. So it's like, it's easy to form a storyline around that type of stuff. So to me, it's like, of course it's going to be accurate because I pretty much know everything that's going on in your life. So, but you know, like he said, I can pull things that most people can't. So anyway, this is about you, Leo, all right? The Sword and the Rose. Clarity and truth coming in for you. All right. Could lead to some type of a, I don't know. We'll see. Sometimes I don't want to get too ahead of myself here. The Golden Mirror. So maybe you're realizing that you might be a little self-absorbed. Might be a little bit narcissistic here. Leos, you guys do tend to get that because we do got the girl with the snake with the narcissist. And the narcissist is here too. So some of you might be like needing to learn from the past here. All right. And realize that, you know, either you're the narcissist or a narcissist is around you. But we'll see. Let's get one more card out for the Leos. We got the coffee cup. So some of you might be meeting somebody new because we got the coffee cup with the date. So you might be meeting up with somebody new. You might be looking at their photographs. You might be missing them. It's somebody that you know. But somebody's a self-absorbed narcissist. I like to love bomb. The boundaries. So I feel like you're realizing that you need to set boundaries here. You're getting clarity about that. It's like this is like a huge like breakthrough here that you're seeing a self-absorbed narcissist for who they are. And that they're realizing that it's only a one-sided relationship, that they're all about themselves. It's all about them, their needs, their wants, all that. And that's all they care about. All right, this one obviously doesn't want to go in. Yeah, see, somebody doesn't know how to show gratitude. Yeah, they're just dark. Dark-ass narcissist. We've got the blossoming. So something's going to blossom. The minute you leave this narcissist here, you're going to meet somebody new. All right? You're going to get back out there. You're going to leave this narcissist in the dust. Yeah. There's going to be an unexpected release between you guys here. All right? Because somebody's releasing the darkness and they're moving into their abundance. All right? Yeah, we see the separation with the Three of Swords at the bottom here. So yeah, releasing yourself from a self-absorbed narcissist. They're fucking everywhere today. Like, I cannot believe how many fucking narcissists we have out here. It's unbelievable. Chances are, if you see a person with a lot of friends, or you see people that feed into arguing and spiteful, just bullshit, they're narcissists. That's a group of narcissists. When you see people more alone and by themselves with less friends, those are usually non-narcissists. Narcissists fit in with the world because they can be fake. They can shift. Yeah, see, there's the narcissist card. All right, you could be dealing with a Libran. So we have here the Knight of Wands here, and then with the Nine of Pentacles. So I feel like you're getting peace of mind. You're starting to be content with this clarity, this truth, and setting these boundaries here. So it could be a young man that's up to 25 years old, but I feel like something came in, whether it was a letter, just something came in that showed one's true colors here. There was some type of deception. The deception, it's finding out that they're a narcissist, I feel. Four of Swords. So somebody could be like claiming that they're sick. They could have mental illness. But it's somebody that needs to just take some time out. There's a lot of much needed relaxing here. All right. After dealing with this fucking narcissist. We have the Ace of Swords. There's that clarity. There's that truth here. But I also see that it's a double-edged sword. I feel that, you know, big changes are coming here with the World card. All right, it's that new person coming in. Might be traveling towards that person. But this relationship is going to blossom here. It's like, because a double-edged sword, it's like when you get clarity, obviously you have... It's something that you didn't see before. So it's kind of like a bittersweet double-edged sword. You're going to meet somebody who is an empress. We have here the Wheel of Fortune. All right, that's your destiny here. There's going to be some delays, but it's necessary delays. But you're going to be abundant. With the abundance card here, it's very expected. Very expected. Once you release this person, yeah. I feel like you found somebody that is... just very nurturing, very beautiful. You released yourself from a narcissist. So let's get an outcome for the Leos. Let's get an outcome. Yeah, all that's been hidden is going to come to surface. And you're going to grow from this experience. All right, because we have here the Queen of Swords here. So yeah, it's... I feel like you're getting clarity over somebody who's very demanding, very authoritative, very cold when it comes to this energy. And then we have the Moon card here. There's just a lot of shit that's hidden here. And that's what narcissists do. They hide shit. All right, Leo. So be careful. I feel like you're eventually going to get clarity when it comes to this. It could be anywhere from like 3 weeks, 3 months. Hopefully not 3 years. All right, the number 18 could hold significance, but I'm going to leave that there. All right, Leos, feel free to hit that like, subscribe, and share.